together. In this week's video, we're going to talk about separating for the sleeves for our Campside cardigan. We've been doing this knit along for a little over a week now, but it's not too late to join. If you need some yarn, check out the links down below. You can get your pattern in the video description down below. And join us, it's definitely not too late. Before we get started, I want to welcome three new patrons to our Purl Together patron family. A hearty thank you to Judy Maguire, Susan Linko, and Carolyn Lambert. Thanks so much for pledging your support. Doing so helps keep these videos coming each and every week. If you're interested in becoming a patron, head over to patreon.com/purltogether. I'd love to see you over there as well. All right, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing I have done is double counted my sections. I've made sure I have the proper number of the front, left, and right. I've made sure I have the proper number of sleeve stitches. There's some cat hair mixed in. I have the proper stitches along the back, the second sleeve, and then the last front panel. So double and triple check your counts because you want those to be correct. Now what I'm going to do is knit to this marker. Then we're going to take some waste yarn and take all these sleeve stitches and put them off on there with just a darning needle. We're just going to take and slip all of those onto some waste yarn, or you can use one of those stitch holders if you like. So I'll just go ahead and knit across to that first marker. All right, so I'm just going along and I'm putting the darning needle through here. Just make sure you're slipping as if to purl because you don't want to twist any of these stitches. You would not want to go in this way and then put it on because that turns the stitch 180 degrees. So you just slip everything off, you know, as if to purl, or think of it going tip to tip straight across. So I'm just going to put that sleeve section off. So I just slip a whole bunch on there at once, and I'm just pulling this through. This is just some waste yarn that I have. It's probably just acrylic, whatever I found a tidbit of. And just make sure that you have plenty of it, because I like to kind of tie mine in a bow at the bottom of what will be the underarm, just to secure it while I'm working the body. And, you know, I'm turning things and shuffling things around. I certainly want to have enough waste yarn on there to secure it. If you have one of those really, really big safety pin looking things, that works too. Okay, let me explain what you're looking at here. So these are, this was the beginning of the round, and here's my front stitches that I began with. Then I took all these stitches off and put it on waste yarn. Now what I'm going to do, you're going to be your sleeve hole. So I'm going to take those two ends of my waste yarn, and I'm actually just going to tie them together and make a little loop, a little bow, just because I want that to stay secured while I'm knitting the body and, you know, doing other stuff. So I'm not gonna tie it real tight. I just wanna make it secure. Alright, after we've tied our bow and secured both ends of the underarm, secured both ends of our what will be the sleeve together. Now the pattern just asks us to cast on four using the backwards loop method. All that is a half hitch. So you're just gonna, if you're a thrower like I am, you're already set up for that. If not, if you throw like this with the working yarn coming off the front of your finger, that's okay. Have it coming off the back of your finger for just a moment, and you're just going to turn your hand over like that and put the yarn over the tip of the needle, and that just makes a loop where the bottom of the loop kind of cinches down on itself. Okay, so you're just going to do four of them like that. That's pretty simple. You can also do the thumb. It's called an E cast on because it's just a loop that looks like a cursive E. Pretty simple. Okay, so if you haven't done that before, we'll just go really slowly. I just wind it around my finger with the working yarn coming off the front and the yarn going to the needle on the back. Just turn your hand over and slide the tip of the needle right on there. Okay, so I've done four like that. That's all you're going to do, and then you're going to continue knitting. So when you continue knitting, just give those first couple of stitches a good little tug and make sure everything's snugged right up because you don't want any holes or gaps right there. We can mitigate some of that if you have a little gap. We can fix some of that when we go pick up, when we start again and pick up the stitches we just put on waste yarn, but it's better not to have any holes in your underarm area. Okay, so just knit across and we're just going to do the same exact thing on the other side. All right, I've knitted across the back and I've put the second sleeve on waist yarn exactly like I did before with my darning needle, and I just tied a little loop bow there. And I'm gonna do this four stitches with the backward cast on again, where I just turn my finger over and put that loop right on so that the working yarn is coming off the bottom of side of the loop. So it kind of tightens down on itself. All right, we're just gonna do three, four like that, and then keep knitting to the end. So we've removed all of our markers Okay, the only other thing you're going to want to do before we start knitting on the body, I like at this point to go and double check that I have the same number of stitches that the pattern says I should. So double count everything again, and then you're just going to purl your way back, purl the wrong side row, and then we're going to begin the chart. Okay, I've knitted up to where we have done that backwards loop cast on, and I want to show you kind of what happens with that. It can be really wonky. It's only just a loop. So it will stretch out quite a lot here, but you have the ability to stretch that back and even out the tension, and I would encourage you to do that. I've made a rather large loop here for the first one that I'm purling into, and then you're going to do the same thing with the next one. Kind of pull that and make it a little bit larger so you're evening out whatever weird spacing and tension that you have going on there with that backwards loop. So obviously that's tightening down as it gets to the tips of the needles, which is smaller in diameter, certainly. And then I'm gonna do that again with the last purl stitch, and then I'm just going across. I'm on my way again. But if you look, if you kind of even that out and look at how that is, it's a little strange, but it'll be okay once we pick this up and begin knitting the sleeve. So, but I would encourage you to space that out, even that out as best you can as you're purling back across. Okay, I'm back to the front left edge, and we're gonna start the chart. So I would encourage you to read again the notes from the designer on page 3. So you're gonna work the chart in order from 1 to 4, and make sure that you highlight whichever one is correct for your size. Okay, a couple things to take note of here real quick that I wanna show you before we get too far into this. You're gonna knit the first however many stitches. Now, I don't know if you're knit what size you're knitting. You need to go through and highlight your sizes so you make sure that you're knitting on the correct chart. Just taking this first one as an example, I'm going to knit across to where this red line begins and then continue across, repeating what's inside the red lines until I get to the end of the row. Now, take notice that the row 1, 3, 5, and 7 are the right side rows. So all the yarn overs and decreases will happen on the right side. And we're just purling back across on the wrong side. So you're just gonna, again, just knit across, repeat what's inside here, the red box, until you get to the end of your row. Now, if you're new to chart reading, I do have a video that's specific to learning to read knitting charts. If you'd like to check that out, you can view that in the upper right hand corner by clicking the little I. They're also put a link down below in the video description. But all you need to do is read across from right to left, reading across here, and then you go up and you purl your way back. You see how it goes. You go across this way, you go up and you turn your work, and then you come back across, up, turn your work, and now you're on the right side again going across this way. So we're reading our chart from right to left, just as we move knit across the stitches across your needle. Okay, I do also have a video about yarn overs. I'll put that down below. Now, another thing, if you look at the project notes that people have done on Ravelry, some people have chosen to omit this very last yarn over and decrease. Now, the last one on the row, not the last one every single repeat, but just the last one when you knit across and you get to the end of your row and the front edge. I'll talk more about that in a moment. I'm on row 3 of the chart, so I am ready to begin our very simple lace pattern. So I'm just gonna do a yarn over. If you're new to this, it's just like wrapping your needle. That's a yarn over. When you're on the knit side, that's it. And then we're just gonna knit 2 together here. That's fine. And then depending on which chart you're knitting, you'll have some regular knit stitches between those actions. Okay, then you're gonna have a yarn over and a knit 2 together. Again, super simple, and you're just going to go across that way the entire row. So let me do that, and then I'll show you what you might consider when you get to the other end of the row. Okay, now with some of the charts, you're going to end at the very end, or the very front edge of the sweater. You're going to do a yarn over and a knit 2 together here at the very edge. Now, there were some notes from some projects on Ravelry that they didn't want to do that last yarn over and knit 2 together right on the very edge of the sweater, because I think that they wondered, or they felt like possibly having a knit 2 together at this very edge might affect how easy it would be to pick up these stitches later when we go to add the front edging. So I'll leave that up to you whether you want to omit that very last yarn over and knit 2 together, which is the last couple of stitches here. You could simply just knit this straight across if you wanted too and omit that last yarn over. Now, is that going to affect the pattern of your cardigan? Well, yeah, a little, because the pattern won't go all the way across to the edge. So I'll leave that up to you, and you can decide how you feel about that. I think I'm going to omit the last one, just like I said, for the ease of me being able to video and show you how we're going to pick up these stitches along the edge later. Okay, for my beginner knitters out there, I'm just going to show you, when you're purling your way back after you've done a row that contains the yarn overs, you're going to come up to that yarn over and think it looks really weird. Just purl right into it as if it's a regular stitch and carry on. Sometimes if I think it's really big and oversized, I'll give this a little pull and make that stitch a little bit bigger too, just to kind of even things out. But truly, it should even out with blocking. Okay, I've completed one repeat of the chart. I'm going to carry on and do several more. So just follow the instructions for your size on the pattern. Okay, so be sure to check on the designer's notes on page 3 and be watching for the point at which you're going to use the larger size needle. I believe that's just before chart 3. I could be mistaken, so you'll want to be careful. Read the pattern carefully and watch for that. So next time we get together, I'll show you the ribbing and the bind off for that, and then we'll be ready to move on to the sleeves. If you find this video is helpful, consider subscribing and hit that thumbs up button. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.